Hello everybody, you are welcome to this channel. I am Atanu Vital. In this video lecture, we discuss about the classification of salts as normal salt, acidic salt, basic salt, complex salt, double salt and mixed salt. So this discussion is going to be very important for you. Let's watch this discussion up to the end. Right now, I would like to remind you that if you are new to this channel or you do not subscribe this channel, then you can subscribe it right now. Let's start our discussions regarding this topic of classification of salts. The salts are classified as the normal salts. At first, we talk about normal salts. In these types of salt, normal salts case, it is formed by the complete replacement of all the hydrogen atoms of the salts. Hydrogen chloride, hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide reacting together to form the sodium chloride and water. This time, this is a base and this is an acid. Acid and base react together to form a salt. And this is called normal salt. Normal salt, it is replaced, it is the acid. For acid, the replacement of hydrogen atom for the acid, the salt forms hydrogen atom in it. So, here total what happens, sodium hydroxide, it forms a salt, sodium chloride and water. Okay, and this type of salts are called normal salts. Normal salts, other examples are like KNO3, potassium nitrate. And how it is formed? The potassium nitrate is formed from the reaction of potassium hydroxide and nitric acid. Nitric acid, this potassium nitrate is called a normal salt. So normal salts, they do not have any replaceable hydrogen atom in their molecule. And these are examples of some normal salts. Okay, now we talk about our next types of salts is that is acid salts. Okay, next type of salts is about acid salts or acidic salts. This type of salts, like when sodium hydroxide reacts with sulfuric acid to produce sodium hydrogen sulfate and water. This one is a salt, and this type of salt is called acid salt. This salt is called acid salt because the salts that have hydrogen atom in its molecule or replaceable hydrogen atom in its molecules are called the acid salts. So for this reason, this sodium hydrogen sulfate is an example of acid salt. Other such examples like sodium hydrogen carbonate, NaCO3, this is also an example of acid salt. And how it is formed? It is formed by sodium hydroxide and the acid H2CO3, hydrogen carbonic acid H2CO3. And when NaOH reacts together, these are forming sodium hydrogen carbonate and water. In this case, sodium hydrogen carbonate is example of an acid salt or acidic salt. So acidic salts are the salts that are formed by the partial replacement of the hydrogen atom of the acid. Hydrogen atom only, it has two hydrogen atom, replaceable hydrogen atom, because it is a dibasic acid, and it has two replaceable hydrogen ion, but only one partial replacement of only one hydrogen by sodium plus, and this one is formed. This is why it is called an acid salt. And on complete replacement of the two hydrogen atoms of this sulfuric acid, means if two complete hydrogen replace, means NaHSO4 plus again H2SO4, that time the complete replacement of hydrogen atom occurs and sodium sulfate plus water is formed. Okay, in the next step means when sodium hydrogen sulfate again reacts with H2SO4, the complete replacement of hydrogen occur, and in this time the sodium sulfate is formed, and sodium sulfate is formed with or you can use the NaOH here for complete replacement of H2SO4. NaOH plus H2SO4, here sodium hydroxide completely replaces the two hydrogen atoms to form the Na2SO4 and H2. So this one is a normal salt, example of normal salt. Normal salt is formed by complete replacement of all the hydrogen atom or ion in the acid. So this is the type of acidic salt or acid salts. Now we discuss about the next type of salts, that is basic salt. And for the basic salt example, suppose magnesium hydroxide and HCl reacts to form MgOHCl and plus water. So this one is called basic salt. This one is called basic salt, which is formed by the replacement of the OH- ion of the base, and this one is formed. This is called basic salt. And other example of such basic salts are like FeOHCl. This one another example of basic salts. Okay. Similarly, the basic salt means the salts that have OH ion, replaceable OH ion in their molecule. So this one is an example of basic salt. And on basic salt, on reacting further with the acid, suppose MgOHCl reacting further with HCl, it will form a normal salt, MgCl2 and plus water. Plus water is formed and the normal salt is formed. This is a normal salt. A normal salt is formed when the further reaction of the basic salts with acid, a normal salt is formed. So this is about the basic salt. Next type of salts that we discuss about is double salts. Double salts are formed by mixing more than one salt together. As for example, potassium sulfate plus aluminium sulfate and water. When mixed together, potassium sulfate and aluminium sulfate, from their saturated solution, a crystallized salt is formed, and this is called K2SO4.N2SO4O3 and .24H2O. This is called potass alum. This is called potass alum, and potass alum is an example of double salt. Double salt is formed by mixing more than one salts, means it is a crystalline solid which is formed from the solution of saturated solution of more than one salts, and the crystalline form of the crystallizes from the saturated solution of more than one salts. And these are examples of double salts. And means potass alum, carnelite. These are examples, carnelite, potass alum, more salt. These are examples of double salts. And double salt do not keep their identity in aqueous solution. Means if we again dissolve in H2O, or if we add water with this potass alum, it will divide into the component ions again. It will divide into its component ions, the ions that are present in this salt, potassium ion, aluminium ion, sulfate ion. These ions are regenerated ionized. These salts dissociates into their component ions in aqueous solution. In aqueous solution, this double salt lose their identity and the ions produce. Okay, So this is about the double salts. Double salts formed by mixing more than one salts, and from the saturated solutions of the mixture of more than one salt, the salt crystallizing out is called double salt. Next type of salts is called complex salt. Complex salts, these are similarly like double salts, and example of the complex salt is K4FeCl4. Potassium ferrocyanide, K4FeCl4, and its IUPAC name is potassium hexacyanido ferrate 2. Okay, this one is an example of complex salt. Here the 4 potassium ions, and if we break this complex salt, it forms this ion, and this is the complex ion, and this is the simple counter ion, and this is the complex salt ferrocyanide ion, potassium ferrocyanide, its full name. And this is the complex ion, and it is called complex salt. Complex salt is formed by similarly the mixing of more than one salts, and from the crystallization of the saturated solution of more than one salt, this type of double salts are formed. And in these types of salts, the double salt the complex salt. Complex salt do not break further into the component ions. Means by adding water to this complex salt, it does not produce the Fe2+ and Cn- ion. Okay. So by in aqueous solution, this salt means FeCn6-4-. This complex ion does not dissociate into the component ions as the Fe2+ and Cn-. This is a complex salt. It does not dissociate further. So this type of salts are called complex salts. Okay. Suppose you can take other examples like CONH3-6Cl2. Okay. So this type of examples where Cobalt-2+ is present. So these are examples of some complex salts. Complex salts is the complex part of the salt is written in the third bracket. So these are about the complex salts. And the next type of salts that we discuss about is the mixed salt. Mixed salts. For example, CaOCl2, and when it is ionized, it produces the calcium-2+ and plus Cl- plus Cl4-. On ionizing the salt, if more than one cation ions are formed, these are called thick mixed salts. Mixed salt, like this one is an example of salt. When it ionizes, it produces calcium+, 2+, chloride ion, and Cl- ion. So this type of salt is called mixed salt. And other examples like sodium, potassium, sulfate. This one is producing sodium+, and potassium+, and sulfate. This one is another example of mixed salt. These two are examples of mixed salt. They are producing more than one cations and anions, cations or anions in their aqueous solution, or in the ionization of these salts. They are producing more than one cation and anions, or cation or anions. This type of salts are called the mixed salts. So this is the complete types of some salts, classification of some salts based on the normal, acidic, basic, neutral, double, etc. nature of salts. So I am discussing this topic of discussions. If you see any question from this topic of discussions, then you can ask me in the comment section below. And if If you find this lecture or these discussions is interesting to you and you get some benefit from this discussion, then you can like and subscribe this channel.